Welcome back to our lecture series on circuits and networks. So in today's class, we were coming to a new area. Actually, it's not a new area, but in syllabus, conventionally, our switching problems are classified as DC case and AC case. DC and AC means only the source is changing. In AC analysis, we are considering AC source. And previously we were considering purely DC source, and all the remaining calculations are exactly same in both the cases. But even though this is a DC source, it is having a sine wave representation like this. If this is 500 sine 2t, it will be like this. Its maximum value will be 500, and 2 is its frequency, omega is 2. Okay, so this is one representation of AC waveform. So anyhow, the source in this problem we are considering is AC source, and for doing this analysis, we are just considering it as a DC with this instantaneous value. Okay, 500 sine 2t is just considered similarly as a DC source, but we have some additional calculations for converting this to its equivalent frequency domain, because previously it will be a voltage source like 10 volt, it will be 10 by s in frequency domain. But for this one, we have to convert the entire term into frequency domain. It is very simple. It is very simple. Nothing is there as a complication. But generally, if you are seeing AC in question paper, people will simply leave it, because students are thinking that it is very difficult. AC is somewhat difficult. It is alternating. Nothing like that. In this analysis, we are just considering the instantaneous case only. At that instant, we are considering it as a AC waveform with having the DC value like that, because 500 sine 2t is considered as a same as that of DC source, but this is having some representation of AC waveform. That's the only case. So it will be more clear while doing the problem. Okay, so initially we are considering RL circuit. So this is the question. Switch S is closed at t is equal to 0. Find I of t. So initially the switch is open. Initially the switch is open and it is going to be closed at t is equal to 0. Find I of t. Okay. So for the solution, we know that initially switch is open means there is no current flow initially through the inductor. Or not only through the inductor, the resistor also carrying no current, because switch was open up to the moment of t is equal to 0. So initially no charge is kept inside the inductor, or inductor is not enjoying a steady state, inductor is not carrying any current. So I 0 minus is 0. So we know that the problem will be somewhat easier, because if I 0 is there, we have to represent that also in S domain circuit. What was the representation of I 0 in S domain circuit? It was I 0 into LS, that is nothing but V 0. This thing we have to represent in S domain, but now it is not there, so we don't have to connect an additional voltage source in series with the inductor in S domain. You can see here, this is S domain figure. I will come to that. Anyhow, you can check only one inductor is there, nothing is there. As if initial current is there, we have to connect some voltage source here. Okay, so switch S was open initially, I 0 minus is 0. Now the next issue is with this 500 sine 2t. we have to convert that to S domain. So L of Laplace of 500 sine 25t. So 50 into Laplace of this term, sine omega t. Sine omega t, what was the Laplace of sine omega t? L of sine omega t or sine omega, that is equal to omega by f square plus omega square. I hope everybody knows this relation. Then this is very simple. 25 by s square plus 25 square. 50 into 25 by s square plus 25 square. That is 1250 by s square plus 625. Now we are coming to the next case. So the initial calculations are over. Initial calculations are over. We got that no initial current was there in the inductor. So initial voltage is absent in series with the inductor in S domain. And now we are moving into S domain analysis for t greater than 0. S domain analysis. We are just converting the time domain circuit into S domain circuit. What is the time domain circuit? It was I of t. But in S domain circuit, we have to write it as I of s. And please write the KVL. Yeah, you can start. Take this as plus minus. For the particular instance, we have to consider like this only. We are taking this as a DC source behavior. So we are seeing negative initially, minus 1250 by s square plus 625. Arrow is entering at plus. Plus 10 into I of s plus 5. S into I of s. Everybody know if we want to convert 5 to S domain, it will be 5S. L in S domain, we have to represent L in time domain, we have to represent as LS in frequency domain. It is clear. And we are not having I0. If I0 is there, we have to connect some voltage source in negative polarity like this. But in this case, I0 is absent. So, no need to connect this voltage source. Okay. Now, it will become 10 IS plus I of s into 5S plus 10, that is equal to 1250 by s square plus 625. On the next step, we can write I of s is equal to, yes, we are taking this one to the right hand side, then we can take 5 out from this one, and that 5 will get cancelled with the numerator. At that time it will become 1250 divided, I will write it. Okay, I will write it. In the denominator it will be s square plus 625 into s plus 2 into 5 will be here, and at the numerator it will be 1250. If you are cancelling this 5 and this 1250, what you will get? It will become 250. So I of s is equal to 250 by s square plus 625 into s plus 2. Now we have to take the inverse Laplace to find I of t. I of t is L inverse of I of s. So we are moving to that area to find the Laplace inverse transform. Okay, so I have written all the steps for finding the inverse Laplace transform in detail. Actually, I know these things are there in our previous lecture very detailed. If you are having doubts with partial fraction technique, you should refer our previous lecture. There is three models of partial fraction technique. Then only you can do this area. Okay, anyhow, I of s is equal to 250 by s square plus 625 into s plus 2. So for partial, doing the partial fraction of such a form where s square, second order term and first order terms are there in the denominator, then we have to substitute like this. By applying partial fraction, I of s is equal to a s plus b by s square plus 25 plus c by s plus 2. So now this both the terms are, we are equating on the left side and right side. This is the first term and this is the partial fraction form. And I am taking the LCM, common. I am taking in a LCM format. So, s square plus 625 by s plus 2 is there in the denominator. So, numerator we will get a cross multiplied term like this. Now, this numerator and this denominator are same. So, we can cancel. Now, 250 is equal to a s plus b into s plus 2 plus c into s square plus 625. Okay. This is our equation that we need to compare the coefficient on both sides. So I am opening the bracket. You please write the entire step. I have eliminated two or three steps here. You can open the bracket. Take your own time. Please open the bracket and arrange the terms like coefficient of s square, coefficient of s and constant like this. Then 250 is equal to a plus c into s square to a plus b into s plus 2b plus 625c. Now I am equating the coefficient on both sides. For s square, in the left side no s square term is there. So left side is 0, right side it is a plus b. So a plus b is equal to 0. This is the first equation. And second equation, for the s term, 2a plus b is there in the right side. For the left side, no s term is there. So 2a plus b is equal to 0. That is the second equation. And third equation is constant. 2b plus 625c is a constant term without coefficient of s, s raised to 0, no s term after. So on the left side it is 250. So 2b plus 625c is equal to 250. Take calculator, solve equations, give unknowns, three unknowns, then put the three equations in the calculator. You will easily get a, b, c like this. It is very easy. Up to the moment, it is very easy. Okay. Now I am going to write. Substitute this a, b, c in I of a partial fraction equation. Okay, in this partial fraction form. So, I of s is equal to minus 0.397 plus b plus 0.795 by s square plus 625 plus c. C is equal to 0.397 by s plus 2. Is it okay? Okay. Now, I think up to this it is very okay. Now, I will. Okay. Let me rub this area. Okay. Okay, let it be there, no issues. So this is the I of s equation. So for bringing it to standard form, I am splitting the first term. So it will give you minus 0.397 by s square plus 625 plus 0.795 into s square plus 625 plus 0.397 by s plus 2. Now, this is in standard form. Okay, 1 minute. There is a small mistake here. We are having an s. A S plus B, so S should be there, so S will be here also. Okay, now this term is S by S square plus omega square format, that is this will give S by S square by omega square is nothing but L inverse of S by S square plus omega square. It is sine not sine I'm sorry S by S square plus omega square is cos omega t. Omega is 25 because omega square, this is 25 square, so cos 25 t, and this is a constant, minus 0.397 into cos 25 t. First term is okay. And for the second term, we have to do a little bit calculations are needed, because this will be in form of omega by S square plus omega square. But anyhow, it is not 25 there. Something else is there. It is 0.795. So it is not the standard form. So I am splitting the numerator into 25 by 0.797. Now you will get, it will be okay, 0.032 into 25. Now it is okay. So I am rearranging the numerator like this. So now plus 0.032 into 25, omega by S square plus omega square, it is sine 25t plus, what is this term, 0.397 is a constant, 1 by S plus 2 is e raised to minus 80. So this is I of S is nothing but L inverse, this is I of T, and I of T is nothing but L inverse of I of S. So this is very easy, but you have to practice partial fraction and this manipulation steps, then only you can solve this. So if you are having any problem, please go back and refer our partial fraction and inverse Laplace transform lectures. Everything is there. So I hope you enjoyed this session. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you.